Recent numbers have shown the world's second largest economy is indeed slowing down. So can Mr. Nguyen make good on his promise? Let's bring in Rajiv Biswas. He's the chief Asia-Pacific economist at IHS Global Insight, and he is joining us from our London studios. Rajiv, it's nice to have you back on the Global Exchange. It's interesting that the Shanghai market is up 3 out of 4 days, and that Wen Jiabao chose his European visit to suggest he will support growth going forward. Is that to outgun the lowered target of 7.5% in your view?
Yes, I think that our expectations are that the Chinese economy will actually grow about 8.5% this year and a similar pace of growth next year. There's no doubt we did see a slowdown at the end of last year and in the first quarter of this year, but we're seeing some green shoots of momentum picking up again. Purchasing manager indices are picking up. We're seeing bank lending picking up. And a lot of this is because monetary policy, which was very tight last year, has started to be relaxed as inflation has come down. So I think the outlook is for some moderate improvement in momentum, although they certainly don't want runaway growth like they saw in 2010.
Indeed. Let's take a closer look at the numbers we just talked about, Rajiv. And the IMF is predicting still that China can grow about 8.2% in 2012. Now, this stacks up against a growth, can I say, that most people were spoiled by, 9.2% in 2011. So this point forward, what are your expectations for the next 2 or 3 years in China? What can we get used to here if China is going to try to slow things down a bit but not let this become a hard landing, if I can put it that way?
There is a risk of a hard landing over the three-year outlook, but we still think the risk is relatively low, maybe in the range of 15% to 20%. So our expectation is still for a soft landing with growth, you know, slightly over 8% over the next 3 years. And this is being driven by a number of factors. Firstly, we're still seeing exports, which are an important growth engine in China, still holding up because of the U.S. market still growing. And emerging market demand for Chinese exports is actually still pretty strong. So even though the Eurozone is in recession, and that's a drag on Chinese exports, it's being mitigated by the strength in other important markets. I think domestic demand is also an important factor. We have seen some slowdown in residential construction, but if we look at the overall picture of infrastructure investment, it's still pretty strong. The government still has very big plans for strong investment, particularly in the western provinces. So there's momentum still there. And I think what we're going to see over the medium term is a major government effort to rebalance the economy towards domestic consumption because they've been over-reliant on exports. And I think it is really the decade of the Chinese consumer. I think we're going to see relatively strong growth in Chinese consumer demand. And increasingly, that's going to be an important factor supporting global growth and helping other OECD countries in terms of their own export momentum. And Germany's been a fantastic example how to tap that.
Yeah, in fact, indeed. In fact, we'll look at the closer look at Apple's numbers and the demand that's coming from China a little bit later in the Global Exchange. I wanted to talk to you about China's toolbox here and the reserves that it has. You talked about domestic spending and building out the infrastructure. Just 2 years ago, Wen Jiabao put forward this fantastic infrastructure package of some $600 billion. Cash reserves of $2.8 trillion, foreign exchange reserves at better than $3 trillion. What is the wisest way to use that sort of surplus capital? They obviously don't want to put it into the European debt bonds, but they want to put it to deploy that domestic demand and a further infrastructure build-out then, Rajiv.
I think we're going to see a huge internationalization of the Chinese corporate sector over the next decade. It's only just begun. We've seen Chinese resource companies doing M&A acquisitions around the world to, you know, acquire oil resources, etc. But I think we're only at the beginning of that process. So we're going to see a lot more long-term foreign direct investment coming out of China into companies all around the world. I'm certain that the Eurozone difficulties right now are seen as an opportunity for China to expand its footprint in developed markets as well. And we've seen some notable acquisitions in the last few years, but I think that will accelerate. as part of this push to internationalize the corporate sector in China. We're seeing the banks in China becoming gradually more international in their approach. And I think this is an important way they're going to deploy those foreign exchange reserves to support those sort of acquisitions and make China much more international and acquire foreign technology as well.
Something we, of course, have to keep an eye on. Rajiv Biswas of IHS Global Insight joining us from our London operation.